Good evening. For almost 2 years, thousands of Qantas staff have been grounded, forced onto benefits or to take other jobs due to the closure of Australia's international borders. But now hope, with the airline fast-tracking its return to overseas flying, and Sydney is set to be the global hub.
Sydney Airport and Qantas International still on the ground, but finally on the move.
We're getting more aircraft back in the air. We're starting more international operations. And very importantly, we're getting more of our people back to work.
11,000 staff in total, most back to work in December. Staff like Second Officer Amy Lynn, who was grounded by the pandemic at the worst possible time.
I received my stand down notice from Qantas when I was on my way to hospital in labour.
We're all here today being pinching ourselves, being like, well, okay, this is a reality. We're all finally going to get back to work.
We don't want to go backwards. We want to open up. We want to bring the world back to our great state.
Sydney will be Australia's main hub for Qantas. The first flights on November 1 to London and Los Angeles. Singapore will be added November 23. The Delhi route first flies on the 6th of December. A day later, flights to Fiji begin. December 18, it's Vancouver. December 19, Tokyo and Honolulu, with Johannesburg, Phuket and Bangkok early in 2022.
In a few hours, a large number of those flights sold out. There's extremely strong demand of people wanting to get back into Australia for Christmas.
It's the first time in a decade that the Flying Kangaroo will make regular trips to India's capital. With a growing Indian community here in Australia, thousands of tickets were sold within hours of the flights being added. The new path, a product of the pandemic.
We have been used to flying to India over the last few months because on behalf of the Australian government, we've done 60 repat flights.
Qantas A380s will be brought back early from the American desert, while Singapore Air announced its flagship fleet will return to Sydney in December. And trips to Bali could be back by New Year's if Indonesia relaxes its quarantine rules.
It varies from place to place, and my advice would be that anyone anticipating on travelling in the next 6 months needs to be dealing with a travel agent because it's not straightforward and the situation is fluid.
It's also difficult for foreign tourists coming here. State borders complicate travel plans and there's still no firm date from the Prime Minister. Today, though, a hint.
We'll be able to move to international visitors, and I'm confident that because of the way we have prepared for this day, that is very possible and very achievable before the end of the year.
Tonight, New South Wales Tourism putting the finishing touches on a new campaign to bring Australia and the world here. It will be launched Sunday. Charles Croucher, Nine News.